Welcome to the lecture series of numerical methods. Today we are going to discuss about iterative methods. What is iterative methods or iteration methods? Iteration methods are actually indirect method. In the previous lectures we have discussed Gauss elimination and Gauss Jordan. That kind of methods are called direct methods. And in this method, that is the iteration method, we can call this as indirect method also. So in this one, how to do the problem means we are going to take the initial approximation first. So with that initial approximation, we are going to apply some steps to get the correct solution or a better solution. So if the rule applied repeatedly, then each successive calculation to determine the next approximation of the solution. So this kind of a procedure is called it as iteration method. So the successive approximations within the equations, that is called it as iterates. So the iteration method, we can say that it is a self-correcting method, because the error made in any computation, within any computation, is corrected in the subsequent iterations. So iterative methods are also called it as indirect method. So the first method we are going to discuss is Gauss serial iteration method. So look at the question, solve the system of equations by Gauss serial method. The system, first equation is 8x minus y plus z equal to 18, 2x plus 5y minus 2z equal to 3, x plus y minus 3z equal to minus 6. So now we'll take the given system of equation, look at that solution. Look at the first equation, 8x minus y plus z equal to 18. As we discussed in the previous lecture, the iteration method can be applied only the given system of equations in the form of diagonally dominant. So if it is not in the diagonally dominant, we have to rearrange the given system in the property of diagonally dominant. So now in the first equation, our first element is 8x. So this element should satisfy the condition of diagonally dominant. Yes, of course, because the second one is minus 1 and here the quotient of z is 1. So 8 is greater than the remaining absolute values of the remaining two elements in that row. So same manner, the second equation also, the y element is the second diagonal element. So this is also satisfying the condition. And here also the 3, absolute value is 3. So that 3 is also satisfying the diagonal dominant property. So the given system is already in the form of diagonally dominant. So we can rearrange the equation 1 as 8x is equal to 18 plus y minus z, which implies x is equal to 1 by 8 into 18 plus y minus z. We can call this as equation 1. Same manner, from the given second equation, 5y. 5y equal to 3 plus 2z minus 2x, which implies y is equal to 1 by 5 into 3 plus 2z minus 2x. We can call this as equation 2. From the last equation, z equal to 3z equal to 6 plus x plus y, which implies z equal to 1 by 3, 6 plus x plus y. Can call this as our equation 2. Now, from the first 1, 2, 3, from the first 3 equations, we can start our iteration. The first iteration 1. What we are going to do is, we are going to give initial approximation. Let y is equal to 0 and z equal to 0 in the equation 1. So what will happen? Substitute in the equation 1, y equal 0, z equal 0. We can get only 18 by 18. So x is equal to 18 by 18. Better bring calculator to the examination hall, so that x is equal to 18 by 8, we can get 2.25. So x is equal to 2.25. So in this, under the iteration method, when we are starting a problem, okay, we have to put a table like this. For each iteration value, we have to form in the table. Okay, so make a table like this. This one we can take our x, y, z values. This is the first iteration, so we can make it as first iteration. What is our x value in the first iteration? 2.25. Likewise, immediately after completing the computation, immediately we can note the values here. Why we are doing like this means, in the iterative methods, we can go for many time number of items, that is number of iterations may be more than 5 or 6. When we can stop the iteration, until we get the two consecutive values are equal, we can stop the iteration. So whenever after completing the calculation, immediately note the values in the tables. Okay, so first value of x is 2.25. okay, now we are going to find the remaining first set of values. What are the remaining values? Y and z. So in this one, look at this, z is there and x is there. So to find the y value, we have to put z equal to 0. Already we have assumed our initial value of z is 0. For the x value, we have to use this one, x is equal to 2.25. okay, in the examination there is no need of writing all these things. If you are very fast to do the calculation work, you can use the calculator directly in the examination. Instead of writing like this, directly you fill the table values and give the value of x, y, z. So for the next one, put, let z equal to 0 and x is equal to 2.25 in equation 2. So our y is equal to 1 by 5 3 plus 0 minus 2 into 2.25. So use the calculator, and within that we can get the y value as minus 0.3. okay, so this is our y. And the same manner, then the last equation we are supposed to use our x and y values. So the value of x, just now we got it, and the value of y is also. So put x is equal to 2.25 and y is equal to minus 0.3 in equation 3, so that we can get the value of z, first iteration value of z. Z is equal to 1 by 3 into 6 plus x, x is 2.25 plus y is minus 0.3. So using calculator, we can get the z value as 2.65. So these three values, that is the first set of x, y, z, that is our first iteration value. So we can note the value in the table. So our x value is minus 0.3 and our z value is 2.65. So this is our first set of values, that is our first iteration. Likewise, we can do the second iteration, third iteration, and so on. When we can stop the procedure, we can stop the iteration until we get the two consecutive values are equal, we can stop the iteration. Now look at the iteration 2. For the first set of iteration value, using this only we are going to find the second set of iteration. Let y is equal to minus 0.3 and z equal to 2.65. use these values in equation 1, we can get x is equal to 1.88. so this is the second iteration of x. Okay, likewise, go for the next value, that is the next value is y. For this y, we have to use the x and z value. Okay, so put x is equal to 1.88 and y is equal to 0.91 in equation 2, so that we can get the z value, z equal to 2.93. you can use calculator and verify your answer. And now the last value of the second iteration is z equal to, put z equal to 2.65 and x is equal to 1.88 in equation 3, we can get our y value is 0.91. so this is our second iteration value. So 1.88, 0.91 and 2.93. so these are the second set of values of the x, y, z. Likewise, we continue the process until we get the two consecutive values are equal. In this problem, the iteration goes till 8th iteration. 7th and 8th iteration, we are getting the equal values. When you are doing the iteration, okay, more or less nearly 4th or 5th iteration itself, you can guess the value of x. Look at this iteration value of x only, 2.25, 1.88, 1.99, 1.99, and it started to 2. So here it is 1.99, that time itself we can guess our x value as to be 2. Likewise, look at the y value also, 0.98, 1, 0.99, 0.9. So obviously the value of y should be 1. Likewise for the z is also 2.99, 2.99, 2.99. So obviously the value of z will be 3. Okay. So likewise only we have to do the Gauss-Seidel iteration method. So under the Gauss-Seidel iteration, how we are supposed to do the problem? First we have to look at the given system of equation which is satisfying the property of diagonally dominant. After checking the property of diagonally dominant, we have to rearrange the given system of equation in the form of x, y, z. So within that, first we have to consider initial value, the y equals 0 and z equals 0. Substituting that value, we can get the first value of x, and using the remaining z equals 0, x is equal to 2.5 in this problem only. Okay, we are getting the value of y, and using the x value and y value, we are getting the z value. Likewise, we have to do the process until we get two consecutive values are equal. So after immediately completing an iteration, make the values in a table so that the problem will be very easier to do this. In the examination, no need to write all the iteration values like this and all. Once only one iteration if you have started to do like this, and remaining values you can just fill it in the table. With the table values itself, we can identify the value of x, y, z. The one or two iteration or three iteration, you can write it like this, because the student should know the procedure how to do the problem. That is the reason why we are writing like this. So in the paper evaluation also, they are expecting that. So you have to do that also. So after completing the table, look at the table values. Here it is continuously we are getting the two consecutive values are equal. So that is the reason why we are stopping the iteration here itself. So this is the procedure under Gauss-Seidel method. Okay, thank you for watching.